Well, there's certainly a lot of cultural significance. Cherry trees are a symbol of rebirth and starting over. So I think for that reason, it resonates with a lot of folks. And of course, they're stunning. So this project started in 2017. Professor Soo-Young Kim and a grad student named Michael Bradshaw, they sort of started this project here on campus, tracking the phases of bloom in order to eventually maybe predict when bloom would happen.
So I can see that these are already in a green bud stage.
Since 2018, undergraduate students, with the help of some grads, have been going around collecting fine-scale data on the phases of bloom that the cherry trees are going through all the way through the spring. Our intention with the data that we've collected, with the help of many, many volunteers, is to use the fine-scale data we have on bloom time and on the way the trees progress through budding in order to achieve bloom, and creating a model that inputs temperature data and links that temperature data to the developmental stage of the trees, with the goal of predicting bloom time in the future. We hope that this will be really applicable and exciting and helpful for folks here who want to plan events, plan trips around that bloom. We have used our model to sort of back predict when bloom occurred historically. We have fed in historical temperature data dating back to 1964 when the trees were initially transplanted. The tricky thing then is we didn't have volunteers back in the 1960s, but what we do have is newspaper records. So oftentimes bloom is published about in the media, and we're able to sort of reference those records to determine with sort of a buffer of certainty when bloom occurred in that year. So this is an article from February 24th, and the text reads, "If the first blossoms to bloom in the quad this year are enough of a sign of spring." We will use our predictions to try to run something for this year. What I'm really hoping to see is that the model's prediction lines up with when we actually see bloom, because then we know we're doing a good job calibrating our model. But beyond that, there's such a global body of literature looking at this specific type of tree and the effects of the warming climate on its bloom time that I'm excited that we'll sort of have a data point coming out of the Pacific Northwest that can maybe add to that broader narrative.